It's time to talk about what I dislike and like about Retune. Right now, it's on a lifetime deal, and that's why we're going to check it out. So Retune is a ChatGPT chat widget that you can add on your website, and it's based on your API. Let me show you what I'm talking about right now. Let's get started. What I dislike about the lifetime plan that they have right now. So first of all, I'm on the AppSumo Tier 1 license. And the first thing I dislike about it is that you can't remove branding until license tier 3. So remove branding. That might change in the future, but right now that is the plan. So this is what you're going to get for the $49. You get everything in hobby. So that's the plan it's tied to. And you get one published chatbot, unlimited personal chatbots, unlimited message per chatbot, users per chatbot, etc. History, training, 50 file uploads. Remember, this is going to use your API key, okay, from OpenAI. And then you got AppSumo Tier 1, AppSumo Tier 2, which it's everything in Tier 1, but you get 5 published chatbots, 500 file uploads, email and chat support with them. So basically, with support, you're not going to get direct support with them. And that's another thing that I really dislike about this license Tier 1. So the support is going to be via Discord. So, I mean, if you're a Discord fan, then it might be fantastic. In my case, I'm not a fan of Discord, and that's not something I use. So that's a no-go for me, okay? And then license tier 3, this is what you're going to get, and this is what's coming. Sync with website crawling, okay? Then you got AppSumo tier 4 plan. You're going to get all of this. Priority, video call, same-day support. So I think that's pretty interesting, this one, because when you're paying $400 and you get this support, then I think it's pretty well worth it if you need things to get done quickly, all right? Now, before I get into how to build the chatbot and how it actually works, let me show you what they plan to have, because right now they don't have everything, okay? So in the settings, you got OpenAI API key and Claude API. If you're in the United States, you can get Claude API and you can use that, which is pretty interesting. Now, in their website, we're gonna be able to view this screenshot. So what they have intended is these models. So right now they got GPT-4, and Claude, but they don't have Llama, they don't have Stable Diffusion, Whisper, or Eleven Labs. So these are not available yet, but I think that's the idea for them, okay? The integrations, again, this is not available right now. It's via HTML link, HTML code that you're gonna embed in your website. And then there's more information here. So just kind of have that in mind of what's coming in the future. For now, this is what's available. Now, to get started, I would suggest that you get started in embedding, okay? So in embedding is where we're gonna get started with create an embed, because that's where we're gonna connect the chatbot with. So I kind of figured this out on my own. So in this case, let's just say that my marketing agency is SaaS Master, and I can add a description if I like. I'll create an embedding. And embedding, I have the option to upload files, so TXT or PDF, so it can grab the information to work with the chatbot, okay? Or scrape a website, which is what I did. And then you have the search feature here. So you can search and answer once you add that data, okay? So in this case, I'm gonna go to my embed, and this is what I'm using, bot. And right now it completed this one. So I'm using a hard filter for on my Cloudflare. That's why it won't grab the information. I'll have to turn that off if I wanna grab that information. But for this link, Vimeo Media, which is one of my agency, This one right here, it's in Spanish. So I have all this information here, and that's where it's gonna pull the information to create my bot, okay? Here it is. So let's go into chatbot. Remember, we connected our website or the documents that we want. Now we need to create a chatbot, okay? So let's go into this one that I created, Vimeo Media, and then we have to write a prompt. So it needs to know what the bot is gonna do. What's it going to answer? What kind of things it's gonna limit to? So this is what it wrote. And I can write this on my own. I can edit this if I like, or we can use the auto prompt to help us. This is really interesting because this is what I wrote and this is the output I got. So it's telling what the bot is going to do and some examples of a chat. So you don't have to manually write all of this. You can just go ahead and add the prompt here, tell it kind of what you want and then generate it. It'll generate it for you. So I think that's interesting. I like that. Then you connect the embedding. So remember, when we scrape the website, we connect it to it, okay? So we have these two, and in this case, it's already connected to the bot, okay? So that's the one I created. It's connected to my website, which is the marketing agency. That's where I have it connected. So that's how it works. Now, before I get into things that I dislike about it, let me give you a quick test. So I added this into one of my sites. Here's a script, which you can grab right here in publish. Here we go. You can grab it here. Show pop-up. identify, etc. Okay, so I added it into one page. I'm not gonna add it into the whole page just for testing. And here is the chatbot, okay? I'm gonna click on it, and this was a test I ran. So first of all, I asked it, what service do you offer? And these are pulled from my website, okay? And then I wanted to make sure, okay? So I said, do you do backlinks? And in this case, yes, marketing backlinks, etc. It kind of right. It's telling me things that are interesting for some people, okay? And then I asked it, are these backlinks manual or automatic, okay? And yes, our backlinks, our building service are primarily manual, okay? Why is that? Because I wanted to know if it was grabbing from this information. So here it is. Here it is. Backlinks manuales, which is in Spanish. It's manual backlinks. So it's grabbing the information from my website and I can continue. So things that I like. So let's go into the dislike before we continue to the rest. And the first of all is they don't have editing for the chat widget as of now. So this is the chat widget, not much editing going on. So you got the branding here, things I don't like. There's the assistant information. So not a lot of editing here. Let me show you in this here. So here's a show pop-up widget. This is all we get the code. It doesn't even tell me if it's left, right, center, up, etc. This is what we get. So we need some settings to put this on the left side or the right side and the margins, if we want to move it a little bit to the right, etc. We need that information. And then we have these other type of embeds available. So show specific thread, a widget in a page, identify with specific user, etc. So you get all of that. And then things I do like is that they provide API. So that's interesting that they provide it even for license tier one, because this gives you a whole nother flexibility to use with other automation systems. If you're using Public Connect, if you're using Zapier, if you're using something else, then you can connect it via API, via this, okay? And in settings, like I mentioned, not a lot of settings available. We can give it a name. So in this case, it's an assistant. We can give it a bot avatar. The model that we want to use, so these are the models that are available. And you can select GPT-4 if you have that available. Then that is possible to use that. The creativity and randomness. So you have the settings for that, which is pretty good that they have that. Limits, so input token limit, the output token limits. Limit threads, limit message per thread, and the branding. If I hover over this, I can unlock it because I'm on license tier one. Like I said, something I dislike that you have to get license tier three to remove the branding. If that's not a big deal for you, then you're good, okay? Then you have your theme color. So we need a whole bunch of more settings to customize our widget. If you want to make this more customizable, we need more settings, okay? So that's for this, okay? And basically, that is it for now. I mean, that is Retune as of now. Do I think it's worth buying? In this case, I would say not right now. If you don't have a chat widget and you need one and you liked what you saw, then you can just go ahead and grab it. But as of now, I think there's a lot of things that need to be implemented before I can actually recommend it, okay? Now, what they do have intended, like I said, based on their image, it's like it's going to be really nice. They have... it's going to be a complete UI redone from what I can see, okay? So it's completely different of what they have intended in the future. Let me actually click play right now, see if we can see it in action. Hi. Because...
welcome to Retune.
Okay. So no, he's actually showing this version. So maybe that's just a mock-up. Maybe that's not where it's heading. But if it is, I think that's the route he has to go, because that looks really nice. If this is going to be the way it's going to be built, then it's a good option. And if it's going to add these other models, then it's going to be a great option. But as of now, like I said, it still needs a lot of work and usage. So we have some usage settings here that are not available yet. Okay. So do consider that when you are thinking about grabbing Retune and decide what you want to grab and if it's worth it for you. But like I mentioned before, right now it still needs a lot of more settings, upgrades, a little bit more friendliness when it comes to building the chatbot. And that is it. That is Retune. If you want to grab it, link will be provided in the description. If you buy it through my link, it helps me out with a small commission and it won't cost you a single cent more than what it already says there. So basically, that is a wrap for Retune.